Greetings people from Beer's Blender, my name is Ronald and welcome back to another video. First of all, I want to apologize for not uploading a video last Wednesday. I was really busy and I was waiting on some stuff to shoot this video. This video was originally planned for Wednesday, but some things got mixed up and, well, I couldn't make it. But yeah, today I can, so yeah. Well, what I am going to talk about today, you might ask. Today I am going to talk about whiskey glassware. Whiskey glasses are kind of a big deal in the whole whiskey experience. So today we are going to talk about some of them. I have some of them right here. Not all of them. I am going to show some pictures in the video when I am going to talk about those. First of all, you have seen me using these ones from the start of the channel. This is kind of a tumbler-shaped glass. This is a glass which is called a Glencairn glass. I'm just talking about this part. This part is not common on a Glencairn. I will show a picture of a Glencairn here on the screen. Probably there somewhere, so you can compare this to that. But this one has a foot, a little stand, and I like it because I can turn it. And that is better in my opinion than rolling. It's more comfortable for me, and I like to grip it and just hold it in this. And for nosing, I like this better. But the whole difference between a glass, a Glencairn glass, and a tumbler. This is a tumbler, for example. This is a full crystal tumbler. This is also kind of a tumbler. This isn't really a whiskey glass, but, well, it works. And this is a whiskey glass, though. This is also a tumbler. And if you order a whiskey at a bar or you ask somebody for a whiskey glass, then you will probably end up with a tumbler-shaped glass. Why is that? That is because whiskey and ice are kind of a big thing in bars, etc. And, well, the Glencairn glasses are not really made for ice. They are fragile, they are not as strong, they are less robust than a heavy, big tumbler glass. This one is really thick and heavy. It's crystal, of course, but this is made for, well, ice. And I will also talk a little bit about something that the tumbler also does not. I will get to that. But let's compare some of the shapes. You could see this glass is straight. It's like kind of like a, I don't want to say a tree log, but it has straight sides, it's hollow, it's just a straight glass. This one is shaped from the belly of the glass, then it curves to the ring of the glass. That's because this shape traps the aromatic vapors from the whiskey, so it's better for nosing. This spreads it way out. And this makes nosing different and harder and not as, well, pleasant because it's heavy and that's not really comfortable. This is just made for easy drinking, and a lot of people don't like the aromas that a whiskey brings. And this shape of glass, the like straight shape, helps with the oxidization because, well, all the vapors can just move out of the glass, and a whiskey connoisseur, let's go with that, doesn't want that. He wants to enjoy every, it wants to enjoy every detail in the nose, and that's just hard with a glass this shape. A lot of people have come up with some different shapes, like this shape, which is a little curved, but still has a big opening, but is also like wide, so it can hold some ice cubes. Personally, I will not add an ice cube to a glass, to a Glencairn glass, because it's fragile and it's awkward. But I don't add ice to whiskey. I don't have a lot of experience with bourbons, but it has been known that bourbons go better with ice than scotches. Just because higher ABV, of course, it is personal. You might find it different, but a lot of people tend to drink bourbon with ice. And well, if I were to drink a bourbon with ice, I would use this glass, because well, it is still a little of that shape. And remember, the nose, when you add ice, it cools off the whiskey. It traps the vapors, the smells, the tastes. It becomes, in my opinion, boring. But for some people, they might like it better or whatever. But yeah, when you start adding ice or a lot of water, it doesn't really matter if you use this glass or this glass. The nose will be ruined either way. I'm not talking adding about a little bit of water, because well, that changes it. But if you add a lot of water, a lot of cool water or ice, just to get rid of some of the for your opinion nasty flavors, then yeah. But yeah, glasses like this also work, because well, they have a wide belly and a narrower top. That's kind of the theme we are going for here. Just a wider belly for, well, ice, and then a narrower top, kind of like a tulip shape, if you know what I mean. I will not ever use this. It is a really nice tumbler, though. It's impressive, it's heavy, it's thick, it has a nice feel, manly feel, yeah, why not? But yeah, for nosing, it's absolutely appalling, so I will not use this. But it's all nice and dandy sitting here talking about all the differences between the glasses. But why don't we experiment some, shall we? Why not? So I am going to get rid of some of the glasses. Yeah, I am going to get drunk really, really quickly here. No, actually not. I will just add a little bit. Yeah. First of all, to the one I used to use, just enough for the nose. Okay. Then to the Glencairn shaped glass, just a little bit. Oh. Then to my new tumbler. This is one I will actually be using for bourbon, because my Elijah Craig needs to air quite a bit in order to be drinkable. And yeah, you can use this glass with scotch, because well, it just accelerates the oxidization. And last of all, let's add some to this. All right, we have some whiskey in all the glasses. I hope you can see everything properly. Yeah, I think you can. Let's put the Bowmore there. All right, let's try these two first. All right. Yeah, this is much, much less intense, and there is a real difference here. I have never actually done this. You can pick up some notes, but it's already a little bit on the dying side. Yeah, I can definitely pick a lot of different scents from the Glencairn glass. So yeah, this one is smellable, but it's less. It's just less of everything. Less smoke, less this, less that. This one is better for nosing, definitely. There also is a Capita nosing glass. I will put that on the screen as well. That's a glass that is industry standard for using whiskey. That also has that tulip shape. But a lot of people tend to go with the Glencairn. This has actually been designed by the master, Richard Patterson himself, not the whole stand shape, but just the Glencairn shape in general. And well, he finds it better this way, and I can agree to him. Yeah, what Glencairns are industry standard. I, by the way, chose a smoky whiskey because that's more intense. So, yeah, this is better for nosing than this one. Yeah. It's, yeah, the shape is not really that different. Opening, I think the opening on this one is actually bigger. But, I don't know, the nose is better on this one. I also like this shape better than this one. This is a little awkward. This is a little bit heavier because of the thick bottom. This one doesn't have that. This is actually a water glass. This is not a real whiskey glass, but I used to use this glass for whiskey. So I thought, let's compare. It is similar. This one is a little bit better, but in my opinion, just go with the Glencairn if you want a nose. But this is nicer in the hand than this one. This feels like a real nice solid glass. I like this a lot. All right, now let's take a look at this one. Or a sniff, I should say. Yeah, I can't smell anything, just some chocolate in the distance. Yeah, nothing. But it's also really thick. The edge is thick. It's so heavy. This is not meant for nosing. This is just meant for being a badass and sipping whiskey. It sips quite nicely, though. Yeah. Yeah, I like this better than that one for sure. It's not bad. This one is absolutely the master, though. Yeah, there is so much going on in the nose with the Glencairn glass. And you don't have to use a Glencairn. Just something that is shaped in this particular way. Just something with a bigger belly than the ring, the top, whatever you want to call it. Just so that the alcohol vapors can be trapped in the belly. Yeah, but I like this way better than a normal Glencairn, just because I can hold it here and, well, don't hold it here, because the normal Glencairn is mostly hold like this with the glass on the bottom. But it warms up the whiskey and I don't like that. And I can sit with my hand on it so that nobody can mooch my whiskey. And it just, I don't know. I like glasses with a feet, you know? Yeah. And the pinky, of course, yeah. The problem with a Glencairn, though, is because the opening is so small, this one you can just sit and take it right up. This one you actually have to bend your head backwards. But the thing also is, whiskey is not consumed in large quantities. Remember, it's about quality, not quantity. So a smaller glass, well, to the eye it looks more than this. There is about the same amount, but you can hardly see anything. But you can still see the color, and you can still see that there's some in here. And this one, no, you really can't see very well. There is still some in here, but yeah, it's about the same amount. But yeah. So, yeah, which one do I like the best? Well, the Glencairn glass, of course. Then this one, the extra proper whiskey tumbler. I like. I will definitely use this for a whiskey that needs to oxidize for a little while. And maybe if I want to add some ice, maybe on a hot summer day or something. This one, it's fine, but I just like the hand feel, the grip on this batter. Nose-wise, no difference. The nose on this is actually appalling, because, well, the vapors cannot be trapped anywhere. It just goes shoop, straight up, and the vapors are actually kind of trapped in this and this, but not as much as the Glencairn, of course. A cognac glass will also work. Anything that has a tulip shape. But, yeah. If you just want to sip whiskey, drink whiskey, and not notice the nose, then, yeah, go for something like this. If you want a nose on your whiskey, but not that pronounced, and you want to add some ice, then, yeah, go with this. Or this. Yeah, I like this. This is a proper whiskey tumbler. It feels nice on the mouth and the lips. I like it. And of course, my precious Glencairn. By the way, the Glencairn glass is kind of fragile, so dishwashers, be careful with dishwashers. Yeah, drinking looks kind of awkward. So in a bar you will most likely get something like this. Or this. By the way, if you're in a bar and ordering a whiskey and some water to go along with it, because, well, it's a high ABV, or I don't know, you like whiskey and water. I have actually been experimenting with some whiskey and water, and I found some really interesting things. So I will definitely use that in my next reviews to come. But when you get like a can of water or something, just ask for a bottle. Just a bottle of water that hasn't been in a fridge, just room temperature. Because it will actually chill. Water from the tap will actually chill your whiskey. I have also heard there is something in tap water that's not good for the whiskey. You need to use bottled water or this or that, or I don't know, but I just use a bottle of spring water, spring water, I believe, that has just been sitting in the pantry, not cool, not hot, just average temperature. Around this time of year it's a little bit cooler, but you don't want anything cool going into your whiskey if you want to still enjoy the nose, etc. If you just want to lower the ABV a little bit, then add some room temperature water, the same temperature as the whiskey, because you don't want it chilled if you want a good nose. Those are some handy tips, my malty friends. Ladies and gentlemen, I am going to head off now. I hope you liked this video. I have been consuming a little bit too much, haven't I? Yeah, I think so. Actually some quite interesting porridge has been happening here, like exact amounts in each glass. I think I need to become a bartender or a whiskey sommelier of some sort. By the way, thanks for watching. I hope you liked it. And if you have any tips or some other things, just share them in the comments. I always love to interact with you people. And hope to see you next Wednesday for another I wanted to say information type video and informative, and that really weird word came out. Every Wednesday or so I will upload a video with some handy to know nice whiskey, what do you want to call it, tips, tricks, I don't know, information, fine by me. Hope you liked it. I will see you again very soon. Don't go anywhere except to the liquor store to buy some whiskeys, because there is always time for that. Thank you for watching and goodbye.